As they have done every Friday night since Christmas, they keep vigil outside the Dondale Youth Detention Centre near Darwin.
We've never missed a week. They go about torturing our children in there.
Grandmothers, supporters, they want the kids inside to know they care, because right now, it feels like nobody else does.
They haven't closed down Dondale. Here in the Northern Territory, they are so cruel about our children. They are dogged about locking our kids up. What kind of world is that?
The Northern Territory has some of the highest incarceration and recidivism rates in the world. To win votes, NT governments like to be seen as tough on crime, in particular, the Indigenous kind.
They see themselves as some sort of hardcore little group of thugs. What we want to do, of course, as a government is protect the people of the Northern Territory.
A Four Corners investigation in 2016 revealed the treatment of 10 to 17-year-olds inside Dondale.
Children in Dondale were tear gassed,
hooded, shackled to chairs, stripped, gassed and hooded,
no water for drinking or washing hands,
solitary confinement, violence,
no air conditioning, no fans,
pushed to breaking point.
I've been treated like an animal, basically.
I don't put it in my mouth, I can't breathe.
The nation was outraged.
It's horrifying to think that that can happen.
I think there's been a culture of cover-up.
We will establish a royal commission.
12 weeks of public hearings culminated in 227 recommendations.
As a victim and a young man, I feel upset and let down by the system.
I am sorry.
If you don't set up a royal commission and then walk away,
something good's got to come out of this. And if it doesn't, we'll be judged as a nation.
In early 2015, all the detained children, almost all of them Indigenous, were moved from the original Dondale facility to a condemned former adult prison 500 metres up the road. Once described as only fit for a bulldozer, this became the new current-day Dondale. And today, 6 years on from a royal commission that recommended the centre be closed immediately and a promise from the NT government to do so, it remains open. It's not only open, but conditions have worsened. There are staff shortages, blood smeared on walls, kids locked down in solitary confinement for around 20 to 23 hours per day. And because of a May 2021 change to NT legislation, which made it tougher for youth to get bail, there's been a 200% increase in youths being detained.
The Territory Government's self-described tougher-than-ever youth bail changes.
Tough new bail laws.
The community is crying out for some protection.
Government observers were supposed to inspect the facility 28 times between May last year and June this year. Yet Freedom of Information documents show they visited only twice.
Visits not happening anywhere near as frequently as they are supposed to.
Two visits over a 14-month period does not suffice.
And most concerningly, an increasing number of despondent detainees are resorting to self-harm.
Rates of self-harm and suicide attempts in Dondale are skyrocketing.
From July 2021 to June of this year, there have been 147 incidents of self-harm or attempted suicides in Dondale.
These are kids, Indigenous kids, and more than 80% of them are there on remand, locked away before they've even been sentenced.
To rub salt into the wounds, this.
The Northern Territory Labor Government is closing Dondale.
A new $70 million youth detention facility is being built nearby in Holtz. It'll be ready mid-next year and will be located right next to the adult prison. Another direct contradiction of the Royal Commission's recommendations.
The minister has defended the site choice, saying the adult prison won't be in view.
We can't see from here, there's no line of sight.
I will guarantee you that the culture of what happens in the adult prison will transfer to the youth justice facility.
So they're grooming our kids to move across the road after they turn 18.
In spite of everything, a determined few continue to fight.
The psychological effect of branding children as criminals cannot be underestimated.
They are the closed Dondale group, and they're a megaphone for the voiceless.
I've been into that facility. It is no place for children. It doesn't offer any sort of rehabilitation.
What it does do is it compounds trauma.
When I was in Dondale, I'm 33 now, but when I was in Dondale, I walked out of Dondale with nothing. They tell us the whole time we're there that you're going to go to adult jail.
I worked there, and I know what it's like, and it's traumatic. It's just another form of genocide, what they've done to my mother. It's a bloody disgrace.
Racism, racism. I'm going to keep saying it.
This bloke is the former NT Bar Association president, John Lawrence. He's represented Dondale detainees and, for years, has broken ranks to speak his mind.
This is reckless negligence.
This is barbarism.
Direct, deliberate, willful child abuse
John is shocked Dondale is still operating.
I've been in it, and it's an absolute hellhole. I mean, it's seriously just a concrete pillbox full of rusted steel, crumbling concrete, keys jangling, noise, bangs, shouts, screams.
John, how would you summarise the treatment of Aboriginal people in the Northern Territory?
Racist.
If it was labelled a national shame and a crisis then, what is the adequate language to describe what it is now?
Australian. I mean, only a country like this could get away with dealing with Aboriginal people like the way they do.
What are you seeing that others aren't?
Well, I'm seeing exactly the same that others aren't. The difference is I'm speaking out.
There are record numbers in there. There's probably over 40 kids in there as we speak.
What would happen if, let's just say, that it was white kids that was being brutalised and jailed at the rates that young Aboriginal children are?
Well, it wouldn't happen. But if it did happen, it would end in 10 minutes.
Jesus Mary! People have to step up.
As for the tragic stories of self-harm, John has heard the worst.
One weekend, four kids were hospitalised. One of them stabbed himself in the stomach. He was taken to the hospital, he was operated on, stitched up. He was placed back in Dondale, and he proceeded to rip out the stitches in his stomach with his hands. And on that same weekend, three other kids self-harmed to the extent that they had to go to hospital. So it's as night follows day, a kid's going to die by his own hand.
The closure of Dondale can happen at the stroke of a pen, if the federal government so desired.
We've written to the Prime Minister.
What did he say?
He said he'd consider it.
And I'll have a look at it, I'll examine it. I certainly will read that.
Well, he wrote back and said that the situation was regrettable and concerning, and it was in the domain of the Northern Territory, so he's not going to do it.
And how did that make you feel?
Livid. Seriously livid. We thought he would intervene, but he's not going to have a bar of it.
We need to do much better.
These are some of the most marginalised kids in the country, yet Australia continues to look the other way.
Don't look what the word indifferent means, and that's what this country is showing. They're showing indifference.
The only way this can stop is for direct action to be taken by citizens, young, old, Indigenous, non-Indigenous.
For those people within the community that just continue to demand a tough-on-crime approach, what's your message to them?
Look, there's a lot of victims of crime in society, and they've got legitimate grievances. They're legitimately frustrated and angry. What we're doing with these kids when we catch them makes an absolute certainty that when they get out, they're going to do exactly the same thing again. This does not work.
There's always the need to have a place where really bad people got to go. 10-year-olds are not really bad people.
What do these children need?
They need love. These kids deserve love.
That's all they need is love.
They don't want to be locked up. They want to have hope.
Most of them need a program that gives them back their worth and tell them that we want you to reach your dreams. Genocide's never really stopped in this country, and really at the heart of that genocide from the beginning has been children. This country, their only default measure is prison. It's in Australia's, this colony's DNA.
That is honestly one of the most distressing things I think I've ever seen. Mm. That's all I have. How is this happening? Mm.
Well, they talk about, you know, closing the centre. That changes nothing. Mm. It's about a culture that exists in the way these kids are treated. It exists in the fact that there's no proper rehabilitation. It exists in the fact that these kids don't think that they deserve to exist because that's what they're being told through the treatment that's being meted out to them.
Yeah. So the Northern Territory government's argument, we mentioned there they're shutting down Dondale and establishing a new one. They're saying that that centre is set up in a new way, on a new approach, which is a therapeutic approach, which is meant to be addressing the kinds of things we're talking about. I guess the problem you have is that is a statement that at this point can only be taken on trust. And it seems like trust is in incredibly short supply in this situation, because when you have... we had a Royal Commission, right? It's not like we know, it's not like there's...
No.
And it's been ignored, from what we can tell. We had Royal Commissions into deaths in custody decades ago. Been ignored.
But while everybody's talking, those children are suffering. It's it's not my place, but it's not OK.
Well...
Sometimes it's interesting to get an outside perspective to remind us just how horrific some of these systems are.